Welcome back to Apple a Day. This is part two of our recreation of the Smallville title sequence, and we're going to resume right where we left off. And as you can see, I have the project open. I'm just going to play it back so you can see where we left off. And here is the actual title sequence from TV's Smallville. So we have a few things left to do in order to finish up this sequence. The first thing is to finalize the look of the animation we've already created. And that will involve adding another zoom blur across the entire logo to give it a light ray effect. And at the same time, we're going to make it brighter and transition it to completely white text. In the actual TV show sequence, as the light passes across the text, only a small portion of that text should be illuminated and the rest of the text needs to fade to black. So we need to add that effect as well. And then we also have to add the larger Smallville text in the foreground, moving slowly to the left and another one moving slowly to the right. Before we get started, just a reminder that I have added the assets to this project in a Dropbox link in the description below. So to add a global glow and light ray effect, which appears across the entire Smallville word near the end of our animation that we've already created, I don't want to mess with what's already been done. So the easiest way to achieve this seamlessly is to add another copy of the Smallville text to the project and to put it in the same position as the existing animation so you can't really tell the difference, and then apply this global effect to that new layer. So the first thing that we want to do is add another copy of the Smallville logo to the project. This is just the PNG file of the entire logo and not the PSD file that we used previously. So make sure that your playhead is at the beginning. Go to your Finder and select the Smallville PNG file and just drag it onto your project. Go back to Motion. So you need to make sure this is in the exact same position as the other logo. So I'm going to blow this up to 200%. And just kind of move over here to the S. And as you can see, it's not overlapping it perfectly. So I'm just going to move it to the left a little, just by dragging it. And that looks pretty bang on. So I'm going to put this back to fit and window. So the Smallville PNG file that we just dragged on there, Motion put it inside the Smallville back group, which is not where we want it to be. So we're going to pull that out of there and move it above to its own group. And we're going to call the group Smallville Glow. And now we need to move the Smallville Glow group ahead in the timeline to the 1 second and 24 frame mark. So I'm going to select it and hit plus 1:24. And that will move it exactly where we need it. So the reason I selected this particular point in the timeline is because I've already worked it out. And also this new glow light ray sequence that we're going to add needs to start roughly when the previous glow is over the I and the L in Smallville. So the next thing we need to do is to copy the colorize filter from the Smallville back layer. And I'm just going to press Command C. And I'm going to select the Smallville PNG that we just added. And I'm going to press Command V to paste it. And now our new Smallville text is the same color as the old one. So now we have to transition this Smallville text to white over time. And the way to do that is to add some keyframes to the colorize filter. Now I don't want it to start fading right at the beginning. So I'm going to move forward about 3 frames in the timeline, just using the arrow keys, 1, 2, 3. And I'm going to go to the inspector and I'm going to go down to the colorize filter and under remap white 2, I'm going to add a keyframe. And then I'm going to jump ahead to the 3 second mark in the timeline. And I'm going to add another keyframe to the remap white 2 property. And here I'm going to make the color white. So if I play that back, you can see that Smallville text turned to white at the end. So now we need to add some light rays. But just like I covered in part one of this tutorial, the light ray effect is a little bit too weak for our purposes. So we're going to use the zoom blur again. So I'm going to select the Smallville layer. And under filters, I'm going to add blur, zoom blur. I'm going to set the amount to 40. And I'm going to go to the beginning of this group. I'm going to add a keyframe to the mix property. I'm going to set that to 0. And then I'm going to move ahead in the timeline to 2 seconds and 20 frames. I'm going to add another keyframe to mix, and I'm going to set that value to 40. And then I'm going to go to the 4 second mark, which is going to be the end of our sequence. I'm going to add one more keyframe to mix, setting it to 0. And then I'm going to go down to my keyframe editor in the bottom. And if you don't see the keyframe editor right here, over on the far right, you've got a little icon here that says Show Hide Keyframe Editor. So just click on that to show it. And what you want to do is select the keyframe we just added. And you're going to right-click on it and select Ease In. And you can see how this went from a straight line to a line having a curve at the end, which is going to make the change we made to the mix property appear smoother on screen. So I'm going to play this back. And that looks pretty good. That's pretty close to what we need it to look like. However, it is missing something. It needs to pop a little bit more. It needs to be a little bit brighter. So we need to add one more effect. And believe it or not, I'm going to add the light ray effect, but mostly for its glow property and not so much for its light rays. So we're going to add this effect to the Smallville glow layer. So select the Smallville glow layer and go to filters, down to glow and light rays. Set the amount to 50 and the glow value to 2. Position your playhead at the very beginning, right there. Add a keyframe to the mix property and change the value to 0. Move your playhead to the 2 second and 17 frame mark. Add another keyframe to mix and set the value to 20. And then move the playhead to the 4 second mark, which is at the end of the sequence. One more keyframe to mix. Add the value to 0. Now if we play that back, that's exactly the effect we want. So this is looking pretty good, except there's one thing we do need to fix. In the TV version, the word Smallville is not lit up like it is on ours. As the light rays move across the word Smallville from letter to letter, only the letter itself is lit up. So in order to fix that, we need to add a moving mask that kind of follows the light as it goes across the word Smallville from letter to letter. And we're going to do that right now. So we want to take what we've created so far and make it its own group. So I'm going to select Smallville Glow and Smallville Back by holding the Shift key. And I'm going to right click and choose Group. And I'm going to call this Smallville Background. So I'm going to make a circle, or rather an oval, which is going to act as the mask that's going to move across the word Smallville. I'm going to make it quite large. And I'm going to move that out of the Smallville Background group, just above it. And the group that it's in, I'm going to name Light Mask. So I'm going to select the Smallville Background group, right click, and choose Add Image Mask. So then I'm going to grab the Light Mask group that we just created and drag that onto the mask source for this image mask. And you'll see that the word Smallville has a mask applied to it. However, it's way too clean of a mask. It needs to be blurred out. So I'm going to select the circle and go to the filters. And under Blur, I'm going to add a Gaussian Blur. So I'm going to choose an amount of 500, which is a good starting point. And the next thing we need to do is position it a little bit better. So I'm going to move it up and over, right about where the light starts. And I'm going to go to the properties for the circle and add a keyframe to the position. And then I'm going to move my playhead forward to right about here before it ends, add another keyframe, and then adjust the X coordinate to the same position as the light source at that point in the timeline. So if I play that back, and that looks pretty good. However, I don't like the fact that the rays are not extending all the way to the bottom and the top of the screen. So I'm going to go to my scale for the circle. Make sure I have the circle selected. I'm going to go to the scale and adjust the Y scale value. I'm just going to crank that up to maybe, what do we say, 600. That should be way more than enough. And of course, you can play around with the X scale as well to adjust the effect to make it look the way you would like it to look, as well as the Gaussian blur. You can play around with the values here. It's tough to make it look exactly like the show. I've tried and I've messed around with this. I spent way too much time just adjusting these values. This is pretty good though, and this should work for achieving the effect that we want. So I'm going to move on. So the next thing we need to fix though, of course, is the fact that the mask is still there at the end when you're supposed to see the whole word. So what I need to do, right before it's at the end, right at that keyframe that we made for the position, I want to add a keyframe to the circle, to the scale value. And then I'm going to move forward about 6 frames. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just using the right arrow key. I'm going to add another keyframe to scale, and I'm going to crank up the X scale, so it covers the entire width. So if you play this back, that's not so bad. So I'm going to move on to the next step, which is adding the Smallville logo to the foreground, moving left across the screen, and then another one right behind it moving to the right. So let's do that right now. So I'm going to go to my Finder and grab the smallville.png file again and drag that onto my project. And the group that it made, I'm going to rename to Smallville Front. I'm actually going to move that underneath the camera. I'm going to reduce my view to 12% so I can see everything. And holding the Shift key down, I'm going to grab the edge of Smallville and drag it up so it's pretty large. I'm going to put this to 25% so it's a little bit easier to see. Now, if you look at the actual TV show, this starts right about here, about that size. Oh, I made a little mistake here. I should have had my playhead at the very beginning. So I'm just going to grab the Smallville front group and drag that all the way to the beginning of the timeline. I'm going to select the Smallville image that we just dragged on there, and I'm going to adjust the Z value to 210, which of course just messed with my scaling. So I'm going to reduce that size a little bit, reposition it right about like that. Now to move this, I could use a keyframe, but I'm going to add the throw behavior under basic motion, throw. And I'm going to open up the throw velocity to show the X, Y, and Z. And I'm going to set the X rate to -422 and the Y rate to 55. So that's going to move it to the left and up. And I chose those values because it has to be at a certain position when it fades off the screen. And that is at the 2 second and 10 frame mark. So I'm just going to move up to that. And I'm going to select the Smallville front group. I'm going to type the letter O on the keyboard, and that's just going to mark the out point for that group. Next thing I want to do is add color to this. So I'm going to go down to the Smallville back and select Smallville back inside that and choose colorize. I'm going to copy that and go back up to the Smallville one that we have here and paste that colorize filter in there. And that makes it match the color of the background logo. I'm also going to set Smallville 1 to have an opacity of 45%. I'm going to now duplicate this by right-clicking and select Duplicate. This is Smallville 2, I'll call it. And the throw has to be in the reverse direction, as well as the starting position. So with my playhead at the beginning, I'm going to grab Smallville 2, and I'm going to move it So it starts out with the two L's right about here. Now this one moves a lot slower than the foreground one, and of course this is going to move to the right. So I'm going to select throw for Smallville 2. So I'm going to set X to 110 and Y can stay the same. And Smallville 2 needs to have a slightly less opacity of 30%. So if I play that back, actually, let me just reset the size of the view area to fit so we can see everything. And just play. One thing I have to do is change the opacity of the entire group. And I'm going to change that to 5%. Now if I play this back, that's pretty good. So I want to fade the foreground Smallville logo in and out. So I'm going to select Smallville front, and under behavior, I'm going to add basic motion and choose fade in, fade out. I want it to fade in 5 frames and out in 30. So if I play that back, yeah, it's not so bad. So one more thing, on the first frame, when the playhead's at the beginning, you can still see the S and the M from Smallville, so I want to fade that in as well. So I'm going to choose Smallville back. Under behaviors, again, I'm going to go to basic motion and add in, fade out. And I'm just going to fade that in 5 frames as well. And I don't want to fade anything out. So if I play it back now, that's a bit better. Now there's one more issue, and that has to do with that mask that we created. I don't quite like that at the end, right there, yeah, I should be able to see the whole word at that point. So I'm going to adjust that mask where it's moving. So I'm going to go to light mask, to circle, to properties, and on my scale, I'm just going to go to the next keyframe. So I'm going to take that keyframe and I'm going to move it. Oh, I'm going to have to increase the size of my timeline. So I'm going to hit the little magnification here to make my timeline wider. So I want to take that keyframe and I'm going to start the scaling up of it sooner. So if I just move it over, and one thing I just noticed is it is a little bit abrupt. And that's because I made the last keyframe 2000, which is probably way too high. So if I put it at 100, obviously that's not enough either. So I'm going to just click and I'm going to drag until it fills the area nice and bright. So right about there. So what's that? Say 625. So yeah, that value should have been 625. I put in 2000. So my apologies. Now if I play this, just going to shrink my timeline again. Go back to the beginning. Deselect. If I hit play. All right, I'm pretty happy with that. Obviously, I could continue to tweak this and make changes to the opacities and the image mask, etc. But I think we're at a good stopping point. This is a pretty good reproduction of the title sequence of TV's Smallville. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and found it useful. Let me know if there's a particular movie or TV show that you want me to try recreating the title sequence from, and I would be happy to give it a shot and provide a tutorial right here on Apple a Day. So that's it for part 2 of recreating the Smallville opening title sequence. Thanks so much for watching. I'm John Martins. Please subscribe, and I will see you next time on Apple a Day.